Alrighty, well, good morning, everybody. Back on again, and that's this is one of my rare morning streams. I called in sick from work last night because pretty much my entire back is just hurting like crazy. Both the tops of my shoulders are hurting, and my front left shoulder here and the upper arm was also kind of hurting as well. So, as I'm pretty much a hurting unit right now, I decided to just go ahead and call in and not make my body any worse than it already is. So, but I'm still in the middle of setting up right now, so just kind of bear with me. But anyway, for the session today, let me see if I can go ahead and post the link up. Headphones aren't working, but anyway, that I'm gonna try to create a new character, and it's pretty much inspired by this comic that I copy cut and pasted and all that, and made it all one big full 3-week running comic thingy. So after being inspired by that, I thought I'd go ahead and create a new character inspired by that comic. And there ain't gonna be any vinyl, so. Hey, what's up? Well, you pretty much got on here just in time. Like I said in the Twitch description, and like I'm talking about right now, I made that Peanuts comic, and that kind of inspired me to create another character. But I don't know how well it's gonna work out. So this is just purely an experiment. But I'm going with Azura, if for no other reason than they're super short, just like the Peanuts characters are. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do about the head and all that. Thief and the Werewolf. What race is a werewolf? Are they the Char? Okay, but let me back up real quick. I'm not gonna play any records or anything. So I'll go ahead and throw the in-game music on. At least for right now. Eventually at some point I might decide to go ahead and throw on a YouTube playlist or something. But we'll see when the time comes. Consider Charlie Brown to be a warrior, so going with him. I'll just leave it the way it is. Or maybe hardly tell the difference. I'll just leave it at that. Skin markings. I wonder if this is one of the reasons why my stream isn't that popular. Is there a... Do you hear a hissing noise in the background? How about now? Okay, that's what you're hearing? Alright. Yeah, I have to... Part of the noise is from the computer itself. And, I also have a box fan. I have a box fan up against the side of the computer. I have that turned on. It's kind of a... Basically a poor man's heat sink. Because even with all the necessary fans inside the computer itself, it still gets a little hot in there. So I had to put a box fan next to the PC in order to blow some more of that hot air out. Gold porcelain. It's the whitest. It's the whitest there is. Oh wait, these are the color of the markings, not the skin. What markings does he have? Oh, hey, what's up, Wild? Yeah, just, like I said in the Twitch description, and like I was telling Matthew, I'm creating a new character here, and I'll post the link. There was a comic that I was reading that I really liked that kind of inspired me to create another character. I'll go ahead and post him up, I'll post it up right now. And, let me know if this link doesn't work. Yes, single player. But it is an MMO though. Okay. Okay, I see what you're talking about. It's not a single-player game. It's an MMO. There have been TV shows made on the comic strip, but the Charlie Brown or. The comic itself is just that. It's a comic strip, and the movies and shows were based on a comic strip. The comic strip first came out back in the 1950s, I think in probably like 1955. So it's even before my time. Okay, there we go. Yep. Yep. He's a warrior. Just like, just like Charlie Brown to me, or just like to me, Charlie Brown is a warrior. This class is a warrior. Oh, and, by the way, this is probably going to be the closest I'll ever come to a roleplay character. So I'm not a big role player myself, but like I said, this is the closest I'll ever get. I don't really do play acting. I mean, what you see is what you get. Yeah, I want them as small as possible. Oh, Ultima Online. Oh, so you go back a while then. Yeah, I think I've tried to play that game maybe one time. Oh, man. Yeah, black, I'll take it. Perfect. Nose high. Yeah, I want the nose kind of up there, just like on the comic strip. All of their noses are like kind of up here, right alongside the eyes, or right between the eyes. They're not down towards the middle of the face. So I want to have that up as high as possible. Stick the lower lip off some. Guess I can do it like that. Chin and jaw. And I think of them. I want to make Charlie Brown's face round. Wish I could zoom this back a little bit. Yeah, I'll keep it massive. I mean, all the Peanuts characters have big old round heads, like way bigger than their necks and the rest of their bodies. So I'll have their head huge. okay, this ain't gonna matter a whole lot because once I get into the game, I'm probably gonna change his, armor colors anyway. For right now, I'll just put it all on clay. Actually, no. Yeah, bright yellow isn't in here. So, but again, for right now, I'll just set everything to clay. No helm at all. So, dignity. And the rest of these are probably going to be the same for all my characters. Builders and architects. Gizmo makers. Alchemagical fractals. Propagate. Mystical complexity. Ooh, that definitely in Charlie Brown. Gizmo maker, so I guess I'll go with statics. My first invention. Waste resource, zero raw, my invention. Well, Charlie Brown's probably most known for a baseball pitcher. He's also a baseball manager as well, so I'll go with the infinity ball. Master Brawl. One of his superior fire. An esopolitical parascientologist? Huh? Not sure on this one. So far I'm probably gonna go with this guy. I guess I'll go with her, or him, whichever. Now for the hard part. Now for the really hard part. Because I'm guessing that, Charlie Brown's already gonna be taken. Yes, no, surprise, surprise. So. I pretty much have to have a middle initial in there because you can't use additional spaces. You can only use one space, and you can't use any kind of symbols. You can use special characters. But the problem with that is, if somebody wants to type down my name, I want them to be able to easily type down my name. I don't want to have to force them to go to the character map to try to figure out what the alt code is just to type down one letter. But unfortunately, I also don't want to have a middle initial in there either. Because I want it to be Charlie Brown. I mean, for some reason, having a middle initial in my main name, Joe Schmo, having E in there doesn't bother me as much. Why? I don't know. But for this here, it's pretty important that it be Charlie Brown, not Charlie M. Brown or anything like that. So, let me pull up the character map. Like I said, I'm not doing this by choice. Let me go back to the character map. I want to see if there's an O with an underscore underneath it, or you know, something like that, something to help hide the special character. And I imagine I ain't far behind. Because I got a feeling I'm going to be playing this game a very long time. Especially with all the money that I've sunk down, that I've already sunk into this game. And I just now have one character that's level 80. Something I'm not proud of, but there are a lot of things that I know now that I wish I knew then. So I'll probably go ahead and go with that one. 0248. Okay, so apparently it's not considered an English letter. So let me go back to the old drawing board. Zero, two, two, three. Nope. That don't work. So it looks like it's gonna have to be, I know what. Either make the first letter or the last letter of the name a special character. This way, when somebody actually tries to type my name down, it'd be a lot easier to either A, hold down Alt and push in the right numbers, and then type down the rest of the name, or B, type down all but the last character of a name, and then use the code. Call the Crown Guards. If you got a link for it, yeah. Nope, that one ain't gonna work. I'm on my character map right now. Looks like I'm not even gonna be able to do that. There's no alt code for N with a little accent on top. So it looks like I might be stuck with one of the O letters. 0240. Nope. Alright, let me try another one. Nope, that don't work. Looks like it's gonna have to be that one. Assuming this isn't taken. Fucking A. But I did say this is gonna be the hardest part of creating a character. I'm trying to find a name that works. Nope. Got it. Not the one, not quite the one I wanted, but.
I am Asura. I personify genius.
I cannot. Poor voice acting on here, contrary to popular opinion.
Driven from the heart of the earth.
Just want to get that out there.
In this bright, wide world. Of course, we've excelled. We exceed expectations in everything we do.
Good video.
Gollum and Gale,
hate the voice acting.
And arcane crystal. We have asserted our supremacy in this land and made it our own. We will not move another inch. Not for dragons, not for anyone. By studying the eternal alchemy, we learn to see the world as a concrete framework. I believe that a steadfast structure requires a firm foundation. I belong to the College of Statics. I surround myself with individuals I respect, and who respect me. Collaboration induces excellence. The crews of my college are built creators. I've just been informed that defective golems, not mine of course, are causing havoc out in the jungle. Whatever the imbeciles outside the city have broken, I'll fix, and make my name doing so. In time, I will construct the edifice of a better world. A world devoid of chaos and destruction. This is my story.
Well, it looks like I just found me another wallpaper. I guess while that's going on, let me, it's gonna seem a bit like cheating.
That's what I always tell them.
Oh shoot. The back slots, they're not account wide. I thought they were. Yow.
Thank you.
level 80 for those, so.
It's pure chaos out here. Unacceptable. What's going on?
Just what it looks like. These golems have gone mad. Zoja suspects someone tampered with them. And by someone, she means the inquest.
Just poor voice acting. I'll explain why here when I can.
If it is the inquest, she's going to need help. Where can I find her?
At the malfunctioning gate that's spitting out these deranged golems. She claims she could feel them on the other side of the gate laughing at us.
Not for long. I'm going to help Zoja shut down the problem at its source. Thanks for the information.
What? Here's... Yeah, thanks, I guess. But, my big gripe with this voice acting, it's no matter what race it is, they all sound the same. You know, you got these little scrunched down scrawny guys that look like Yoda. They should be sounding like Yoda, or something akin to him, you know? Maybe have a really high squeaky voice or something, you know, or, you know, like the gnomes in World of Warcraft. The gnomes in there sound like frickin' gnomes. You know, the Tauren. The big, huge bull race in World of Warcraft.
They all have low, deep voices.
You know, they sound like frickin' Tauren. And here, well, they sound like your neighbor down the street. Just your normal, everyday guys. I think probably the worst example, I forget the name of the frog race, but you know, their mouths are like this big and... Yet if you listen to them, oh no, our city is under attack. And they sound like normal people, not like, you know, like,
Ribbit, they don't run for something.
You know, or, you know, sounding frog-like. No, they sound like, somebody at a bar, one of your buddies at the bar or something. Ticks me off to no end whenever I hear this.
Show you what dangerous really means. Why don't all of you give these folks a proper welcome?
That won't surprise me. We got more on the way. The impenetrable waist-high fence. Steve, huh? What kind of attacks is he gonna have? Lurdy birdie.
it's you again. I see you survived with your epidermis intact.
Of course. It takes more than a giant rampaging inquest golem to get the better of me.
Modest, too. Well, you've earned a dash of praise, if you ask me. The crews around the city would kill for the assistance of an inventor with your talents. You should ask around. Make yourself invaluable.
Not a bad idea. Thanks. Completion leads to satisfaction.
The old crab trap micro. That'd be cool. He could mine the battlefield and stuff like that.
Welcome to Metrica Province. You'll find private laboratories all over where our crews work on dangerous research. And we pay the price for excellence. Labs need to be carefully maintained. Sure, that's not news to you. We see a fair bit of interference from the inquest. They're envious of our advances and covered our research materials. Our researchers could use someone with your talents. On your journey, you may.
Yeah. What I'm supposed to do here. Yeah.
Power core stable. Explosion in 5, 4, 3 resumes normal functioning.
No idea what I'm supposed to do there. Pick one at random. Nope, can't do them. And, there's no need for me to test this guy out in PvP because my man is a warrior, so.
Pursuit normal functioning. PM900A security golems are malfunctioning. Somebody do something.
Here we go. No idea what to do there. Running out of things to do here. Level up. Eating egg tarts? Never heard of those before.
Do you desire unrivaled power? Speak with me if you're interested.
But yeah, you are right. These early quests here are gonna get pretty boring. Booze, booze.
I'll be on my way.
My crew is on the verge of a breakthrough.
So what exactly are egg tarts? Are they anything like Pop Tarts? But with basically breakfast Pop Tarts? Quite hard to explain. Excuse me. Alright, so let's go fight this thing over here. Quite hard to explain. Oh, okay. I need that. For the most part, this guy's build, unless I can think of something more creative, is pretty much gonna be the same as my mains. Probably gonna be either dual wielding axes, or it'll be wielding probably a mace and a warhorn, meant for group support. It's like a pizza, but... Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that's multi-target. Yeah, probably gonna have to. Yeah, once I get this whole thing taken care of here, I'll probably look it up. Did it.
And the sneaky mitts of experiment. They befouled my research.
Surely you can recall whatever experience.
First, I'm gonna head over here and unlock this waypoint first. Egg tarts. Yep, there I am, bathed in white light. Okay, so it kind of looks like pumpkin pie, but with eggs instead. I'd like something, you know, kind of mixed in with the eggs in this. Like a chicken pot pie, but with an upper crust though. That's a longbow. No. Oh, excuse me. Now that I think about it, maybe I'll make his really? Well, I mean, looks like Charlie Brown up to bat. Maybe I'll make his main weapon a greatsword. I'd have to pick up a hammer somewhere though to see how that looks on him. Still need to look into getting swiftness too. sky is low. I'm gonna go ahead and take the headphones off. And yeah, I should probably mention another reason why I'm doing that. Is I don't know if you can see it, but part of the earmuff just broke off. Or just tore off, I should say. Did it. So he's all taken care of, so guess I'll head north and learn how to dodge. Just go ahead and auto run. There she is.
Interesting. Destroy you.
So what, you only get a limited supply of them? Yeah, I was also under the impression that you can only grab one color and that's it.
Greetings.
Never mind. And all stupid me, I picked the same color. See if I can switch out. Just one?
Ideas are like
hey, researcher, can I have more than one? Excuse me. Also means I can dual wield. Okay, I remember this one.
Oh.
Still like my greatsword. Looks like Charlie Brown's up to bat. Boy, sure wiped off this area. That it knocks him back.
Beaten you, but you don't know it yet.
Mighty Warhorn. So, and raised behind this, Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown is a baseball manager, so Happy Go Warhorn is a pretty legit item.
Accelerate.
And it's got swiftness, though. All the more reason to hold on to this.
Sure.
level up. And I got my number 5 skill. And got all 5 of my abilities. This is probably also one of the reasons why I like this game so much. You get all 5 of your abilities and I'm like, what? Level 8? I believe this is what they refer, this is what they call horizontal progression. I remember reading about this some time ago, whereas most other games I've played where it's all vertical progression, where the stuff you get, where it's basically stat-based, it's all about a gear level, or gear score, item level, your numbers just keep going up and up and up and up and up and up and up. Here, you get most everything you need, at least as far as abilities go, you get most everything you need super early in the game. I mean, I got my basic abilities now. And I'm only level 8, so already I'm going to be able to learn to play my class. And you get the majority of these. You don't get them right away, but you get that at level 19 and you get that at level 31. So it's not like Final Fantasy 14. And I guess World of Warcraft as well. You don't get all your abilities until level 70, like level 76, 78, level 80. Then you get your final ability at the max level. Here you get most all your abilities just pretty much like that. Oh, thank you, Matt. And I might be wrong about this, but I think another version of, or another aspect of horizontal progression is, again, I might be wrong about this. If I can find a good example. Like, all of your, let's say your level 6 blue gear is gonna have, or this probably might be a better example. Like, you got a, oh God, I'm trying to find a good example here. I think that's a, yeah, that's a two-handed weapon. 158 to 174, level 6. But basically, all of your level 8 two-handed blue gear is going to have the exact same stats, 158 to 174. All of your level 6 blue gear, two-handed blue gear, is going to have exactly those stats. Like, probably your level 80, like, what would you say, your level 80 pink greatswords are all going to have the exact same stats no matter where you get it from. If you get, if I'm guessing right, you can run PvP until you have enough PvP currency to buy a PvP pink greatsword, and it's gonna have the same exact stats as a pink PvE sword, or like a pink greatsword, or you can get a level 80 pink greatsword from doing world versus world, and it's gonna have the same exact stats as a PvP would, and a PvE, and a crafting one, etc. So you basically obtain the best in slot gear no matter what you do. So that's probably another aspect of horizontal progression right there. Whereas most other MMOs, the only way to get the best quality gear is running raids. Anything else is less. That's all it was in World of Warcraft, that's all it is in Final Fantasy 14, and pretty much just about, I think probably RuneScape as well. You know, the only way to get the best in slot gear was you gotta run the raids. You gotta run the super hardcore heroic content. I'm under the impression in this game here, you can get best in slot gear no matter what mode you do. Whether it's fractals, whether you're doing PvP, all the top tier gear in those game modes are all gonna have the same stats. At least Again, at least that's how I'm understanding it. If I'm wrong, feel free to let me know. I guess. I've only heard the name, Breath of the Wild. I think I've maybe seen little, tiny snippets of it. But yeah, that... If it's anything like that, then yeah, that'd be another pretty good game to play there, too. Because if all of your endgame gear has the same exact stats, then that means you could have the best gear in the entire game, no matter what you do. Well, they got another one coming out, huh? And I'm also guessing, Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, is that another MMO? But like I said, I've only heard the name of it, and I've only seen like really tiny snippets of the game. But, is it multiplayer, though? Okay. So, in other words, what I just said is pretty much like your game, though. Like, eventually, all the weapons that are basically all the equipment you pick up, it's gonna have the same stats. I guess I'm heading back here. Apparently there was something I missed. I just gotta figure out how to get over there. Mario 35, huh? There's 35 Mario games out there, huh? So, there it goes. The indomitable waist-high fence. Yeah, there it is. The insurmountable waist-high fence. That seems to be a pretty common issue in this game. Like, you know, I would have thought I'd be able to jump over this. Oh, that's right, I got a glider. Totally forgot about that. Okay, I gotta keep heading west. Whenever you hear me say the insurmountable waist-high fence, that's what I'm talking about. It's basically Tetris 35. Oh, okay. Is it anything like a Dr. Mario? This again. There we go. Pardon me, guys. Classic Mario. Okay. So now I gotta figure out how to get over there.
The marsh north of Soren Dra is remarkably tumultuous. Senior researcher Shun and his salvage crew clash with the inquest as they race to unearth an artifact at the Old Golem Foundry site. Across the river from the Old Golem Foundry, the Brill Alliance crew has begun researching Skrit, who make for troublesome, uncooperative test subjects. These crews can always use it.
Oh, okay, like World 1-1. Alright, so... okay, I'm gonna stop right here. Okay, first off, what I'm gonna do is I'll log out on this guy, and then I'm gonna go on one of these other guys that I don't even play anymore. I believe I have I'm hoping the hell it's account bound and not soul bound, but they're called Unbreakable Gathering Tools. Normally, gathering in this game, you know, you got a pickaxe, you got a scythe, and you have an axe, a wood chopping axe, and those three have limited uses. But through microtransactions, I bought what are called unbreakable gathering tools, where it's unlimited use, and they can be used on all the nodes in the game. So, but synth. I'm talking of all the, like, if you saw what I did a moment ago, I stopped right in front of that tree. That tree, you can chop wood from that particular tree. But the way gathering works in this game is, normally you got a wood cutting axe, you got a scythe. It's a, like a Grim Reaper scythe. You use it for, whoosh, 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 you know, like threshing grain and stuff like that. You got that, and then you have a pickaxe for mining. But in this game here, you only have a limited, each one of those has a limited number of uses. But through microtransactions, you can buy what's called unbreakable versions of those. They never break. You can use them infinitely, and they'll also chop down any node in the game. Whereas, in the early part of the game, the stuff you can buy is only good for, like the real, really low level wood, that kind of thing. So, but before I even get started on that, I'm gonna break off here for about 5 or 10 minutes or so, and I'm gotta use the bathroom, and while I'm up, I'm probably going to get me something else to eat and drink as well. So, yeah. I'll just finish off the tea I got, and then just rely on water afterwards. But I'll be back. try something real quick. I don't know what to do to get that to work. You would think it would. Here, I'm trying to get something to work on this. Can't see why it wouldn't work. Yeah, I can't see why it wouldn't work. Well, let me try this. God, picky, picky, picky. Alright, guess not. I guess I'll just do it like this then. But anyway, what I'm gonna try making, I'm gonna have me a couple cans of chicken of the sea salmon. And I'm gonna have some rice, broccoli, and cauliflower. So it'll be, it'll probably be another 5-10 minutes on top of me showing you this, so, because this here is going to take about 5.5 minutes to cook. I'll be back. Okay, so, I'll tell you what, since it's going to take about 5.5 minutes to cook, I'll just go ahead and come on back. I'll pick him. And hoping to hell these are all. The stuff I'm after is account-bound and not soul-bound. Nope, he ain't got him. Guess I'll have to try another character. Well, let me see if he's got him. It's account bound, so I can't do it.
Find everything you need here.
And I got the slots for it. So here we are. Unbreakable mining pick. Okay, so now I can chop it down. Hot house.
Vitality restored.
Following you. Okay, I guess now she's just gonna stand there and do nothing.
gods before they can render more evil.
Missed one. And then after this, I gotta go check on my food. Go and a level up.
We were amazing, but let's not celebrate just yet. We still have to get out of here in one piece. Inject some hustle in your step. Let's keep moving. Careful, it's trapped.
Yeah. Advance no farther. You will pay for what you've done to our lab.
Oh yeah? Who's going to enforce this payment?
Thank you for asking. I'd like you to meet my enforcers. Inquest Golem Assault Force, activate.
Okay, I guess I can't move past there.
You couldn't hope to fathom its capabilities and intricacies.
Activation complete. Intruders will be killed.
I'd like to know how to get out of here. Oh, it looks like I... Oh, never mind, it's the wall. Alright, let me find a safe spot. Okay. Alright, now I'll go ahead and check out my food, get it all prepped and cooked and all that stuff, so I'll be back in a bit. Okay. So to start with, I showed you a little while ago, but this is rice, broccoli, and cauliflower. And in it, got me some white cheddar popcorn seasoning. And then, made me some salmon. With nacho cheddar popcorn seasoning. Take care of her. So now I gotta find a way to get out of here. Well, the insurmountable waist high railing. Shit. Well, guess what Joe gets to do? I have to log out again? So now I gotta make bags for my guy. Now I gotta make room for it. The fan comes back on because my hand's starting to get all sweaty and sticky. I have to have a fan blowing over my mouth just to keep it all cool and dry. Take care of that. Let's get all the crafting mats in there. And I can destroy these since I don't need them.
Simplicity.
So now I gotta figure out how to get over there. There it is. That's right, gotta find it. Bullshit. Bullshit. Looking right at it. I don't know why the... Oh, that kind of sucks. I gotta upgrade my gear. Nice. Got a blue war horn.
Power 4 unstable. An explosion on 5, 4, 3.
We'll be fighting these guys again.
There's some very interesting research going on in...
the insurmountable waist-high fence.
Accelerate!
Kind of overshot him there, buddy. Just barely.
Whenever the kids are out of school, I worry.
Don't worry. We'll keep them safe from hiding this time.
Concerned about kid mischief.
Is still out. This means I'm gonna have to once again switch characters. Whoops. So now I gotta. Hopefully, there's an armor smith around here. Don't want to mess with those Sheik lurkers. They disappear and reappear on you.
I need someone competent. Accelerate! Maybe you!
More stuffy stuff.
All right, so that one's squared away. He's just toddling into bed. So let's head over there. Out of bronze.
A moment too soon. Put your best prize-winning game face on. We're up next.
So far, it's all power couplings and energy matrices. Boring! Our device is clearly the best.
Grab the device and get ready. Kozak will back you up and assist during the demonstration.
Hello again. I was just admiring your entry. Helping me smash inquest columns, not enough for you, eh? I like an ambitious inventor.
Thanks, but you haven't seen anything yet.
Next types are too conservative and deliberate for my taste, but I think you've got a real shot at this year's Snap Prize.
We're up, apprentice. If you can tear yourself away from the founder of this event, the other judges are waiting.
Like always, just poor voice acting.
Better get moving. On behalf of the judges panel, and in memory of my beloved...
Now that I think about it, it can either be the bad voice acting, or the bad direction.
World is very impressive.
Keep dreaming,
I mean, really, these are short, scrawny guys. They should be, you know, have high-pitched, squeaky voices, you know, that kind of thing. And not just normal human voices.
My crew's Snap Prize entry, the very old energy detector, or VOED. It locates ancient and or powerful magic, be it manufactured or naturally occurring. If it exists and it's got magical oomph, the VOED will find it.
That certainly sounds impressive, but ideas alone will not win you the Snaff Prize. You'll need to demonstrate your device for us.
Of course, Counselor. Just give me a moment with the VOED and I'll locate the most mind-blowing magical item in the immediate vicinity.
Time to do this, but it's gray at. I just saw it. Oh, that's brown.
There. There's a signal coming from over there.
Thank you.
some kind of oblate oval. An egg.
An egg? Your very old energy detector detected an egg. I'm not impressed.
One egg to rule them all.
Aha! Behold! From nothing.
That I'm assuming I have to fight.
Got the double bit bigger and call them George.
Let's go, Shrieksy. On to the next relic.
Give me another signal.
Is that a head? I'm not used to looking for powerful magical artifacts that can look bad.
Is that all you've got? The head of a statue?
It's an egg and a head. It's an egghead!
This might be a priceless artifact of an ancient culture.
It looks human to me, and therefore worthless. Bring me something extraordinary.
Let's get out of here.
The readout is going crazy. That way.
Ooh, that looks expensive. The jig is well worth
it. Damn stink bomb.
You've certainly found something. But is that item anything of consequence?
Hard to say without more extensive research, but it's steeped in powerful magic. How'd you feel? It's fairly crackling with arcane energy.
I believe I do feel. Yes. It's hard to deny that artifact's considerable presence. Your Voed may be about to win you the Snaff Prize. First, we need to know more. If you could just... Hang on. Does anyone else feel that? It's like a highly pressurized wave of ionized particles. A magical storm. What's going on here? What has your device unleashed? By the eternal help of that's an element. Destroy it before it enkindles us all. Nearly got us all killed. The judges are unlikely to weigh this in your favor.
But we just proved how effective the Voed is. The artifact is dangerous.
And no, I don't have my earphones on, so I can't hear what they're saying. One, my earphones are on the fritz right now. It hisses and part of the insulation padding is ripped off.
Very well.
And secondly, the voice acting in this game sucks.
It's
contrary to popular belief.
Science, I declare the Voed victorious. Congratulations.
Outstanding. Paka, I'm getting another signal from the Voed. It's similar to the first and not too far from here. I'd like to check it out.
And I'd like to accompany you. I'm seeing a lot of potential in this device. And in the crew that made it.
By all means, go. Find this new artifact, render it harmless, and bring it before the Council. We want to make sure you get the credit you deserve.
Before we go any further, we have to decide who gets to carry the Snaff Savant title. Ah, yes. So, if Kazek is recusing himself, that makes the decision an easy one. Congratulations. For your hard work and diligence, you are hereafter the Snaff Prize Savant.
must be a channel under it.
Stay here, Shrieksy. I want to get away.
Not yet, I guess.
So glad you could join us, Zoja. The Savant and my entire crew welcome your input. Crew, the signal
and,
is here,
when I get
but
a chance,
I don't see
I'm gonna have to break off for a few minutes. I gotta clean my
as
bowls
staff
out.
Prize winners, we are the
and
for the
I get something else
status.
To eat, too.
Kozik was right. Titles do come with responsibility. These readings are still in the red. There has to be something here.
Perhaps we're standing right on top of it. We haven't been on the surface so long we've forgotten how to dig, have we? Not that we'll actually dig, mind you. There's bound to be a tunnel or cavern entrance around here somewhere. We just need to find it. And, Savant? Considering the dangerous nature of your last discovery, I recommend we keep our guard up. Shall we proceed? The correct answer is yes, by the way.
Thanks for deciding for me, Zaja. Appreciate that. It's behind a waterfall.
Health increasing. Follow this locale no more. I die invincible.
So where are we going? I just saw something about behind the waterfall. Nowhere to go. Wrong button. Well, apparently, this guy up here couldn't wait. Something nailed me. Why am I taking damage? Or I should say, why am I taking excess damage? Why do I have everybody and their dog on me? Heal, please. Heal, please.
have our item. So, Savant, tell me. What do we have?
I'm not sure. The Voed just tells us where it is and how magical it is. This thing here is packed with arcane energy. A cursory visual examination tells me it's part of something larger. Something that was accidentally broken or intentionally modular.
Well, we can't learn any more here among these damn foul-tempered beasts. Let's get the relic back to our lab and run some tests.
I'll leave it to you. You're not the only ones with big projects that need managing. But if you need more input from me, all you have to do is ask.
And finish.
Level up. Oh, that's right. I don't get a speed buff until 21 went up. Or at least 21 where I think it's discipline. Shot ability. How about that? I already got a good chunk of my abilities that I use. Damn, a lot of debtors down there. Let's see if I can revive some of them. Oh, wait, this is part of the hearts. Wanna run into that thing. Okay. Now I'll auto run. And then I think probably what I'm gonna go ahead and do is once I've earned this hero point, I'll probably do some logistical stuff, and then after that I'll just go ahead and shut down.
Adrenaline rising.
Oh, hey, what's up, Martyr? Stacks of might. What are you doing, gouging prices? And you gotta jack the prices up on them all? Doing the pump and dump, huh? Pawn shop, yep.
Accelerate.
Oh, this is my new character. If I can have. I'll show you what he's all about if I can find a free area. But, last night, when I was working on my blog post, hopefully it's still here. No. To say, I got it, and I'm about to gouge it. But I made a comic about that. It just, I was inspired by that. I just went ahead and created a new guy named Charlie Brown. Did he take you up on it, or did he tell you to go fuck yourself?
You crossed the line.
So, got a big, huge, massive guy that probably don't need my help.
Accelerate. Increasing.
Yeah, I guess I can see that. Well, obviously not. You're the one holding all the cards. Or all the gear in this case. Huh? You gotta swoop up on that too, huh? That's all you need? Just more 80 gear? Or do you need, like, some kind of currency, too? Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was gonna say, I know it couldn't have been that easy. What tombstones are you talking about? Sounds like you're talking about the Stones of Poetics. Okay. Yeah, you can run damn near anything, you can get those. I want to see what that hammer looks like on me. If it looks like I'm wielding a baseball bat, I'm probably going to keep it.
Gate traffic is way up.
Yeah, I'll stick with Greatsword. And I totally forgot too that
funds to spare.
You're not very mobile with a hammer, so. Switch back to Greatsword. And I still got hit with it anyway. There it is. Okay, I'm gonna try to get up on top and discover that. On the way up. The insurmountable waist high fence.
Remind me, what exactly is it we're hoping to prove?
That two script are smarter than one script. And three script are smarter than two script.
So basically, we're just measuring script for brains.
You've just been dying to save it.
I want to say it's got something to do with this tree. Looks like this one here, I might have to look up on YouTube.
I've observed script IQs increase as the number of an increased signal comes up.
So I'll chop this down. Because other than this tree, I don't know. Yeah. I think I might have to YouTube this one. But
thank you.
here is what I was looking for.
They see a sword on Hunting Highland, and they lose all interest in commoners.
All prices are non-negotiable.
Here is my temporary home. Oh, they're all way up here. Huh? Well, another vista. That's probably way the hell up here. That I'm probably gonna have to go on YouTube in order to find. But otherwise, I'll just go ahead and shut it down here. I got extra stuff I gotta do. I still gotta go to my blog post. I gotta get this recorded onto it, so still gonna be pretty busy. Plus I still gotta shower and shave and all that, so. But otherwise, glad my new character went through. And I'll most likely on my evening session, which would be somewhere between 3:30 to 4 p.m. U.S. Central Time, I'll most likely be playing this guy again. The Continuing Adventures of Charlie Brown. But aside from that, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And just like I said, I should be on later on this evening, somewhere between 3:30 to 4 p.m. And that is U.S. Central Time. So, but until then, thanks again for coming, everybody, and see you all next time.